first and 10, wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky, has it inside the 10.
Still with it, Diana Powerhouse!
Ilfil Velez on the run, diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move, goes to the rim, got it to go!
Hi, friends, and welcome to the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam. It is great to have you with us. All is quiet here in Frost Arena as the winter sports season has come to an end. We're going to take you back through what was an exciting November, December, January, February, all the way through March on this week's show. In addition, the spring sports are heating up. We'll give you a preview of what's to come as things go outdoors here in the spring for South Dakota State Athletics. But let's start with the Jackrabbit Wrestling Program, who capped off their campaign with their first two All-Americans since joining the ranks of Division I.
The South Dakota State wrestling team achieved new heights during the past season. At the same time, head coach Chris Bono is adamant that this program is not content with the success of the 2016-17 campaign. The Jacks lose two starters off of a team that set records for attendance and Division I dual victories. The season opened with a home duel against Iowa State. SDSU won 7 of the 10 matches against the Cyclones, dominating in front of almost 2,000 fans. SDSU 27, Iowa State 9 was the final. A month later, the Jacks lost to third-ranked Iowa in Brookings, but drew over 4,000 fans to Frost Arena in the process. And those two duels against the Iowa schools showed the support of Jackrabbit wrestling is not only growing, but doing so at an exponential level. Bono's grapplers rattled off 7 straight duel victories in January and 11 of 12 into February. The most memorable night of the season is also one of the highlights of Jackrabbit wrestling over the 40-plus year history of the sport in Frost Arena. SDSU hosted Oklahoma in a meeting of two nationally ranked teams in Big 12 competition. The Sooners won 3 of the first 4 matches, but the Jacks won the next 3. With one match remaining, SDSU trailed the duel 19-13. But that one match was the 133-pound affair, including Seth Gross. At 2 minutes and 24 seconds into the match, Gross pinned Trey Blackwell's shoulders to the mat. The nearly 2,000 in Frost Arena came unglued. With the dual score even at 19, the Jacks won the match based on criteria. A win for the ages, and Gross's legend grew. The Jacks wrapped up the regular year against North Dakota State with the Border Bell at stake. 3 major decisions and a pinfall win by Gross led the Jacks to a 20-18 win over the Bison, their third straight over the I-29 rival. And the Jacks finished the season 14-5, 8-1 in the Big 12 Conference. On to the Big 12 Championships, where SDSU would take third in the 10-team event. Gross led the way by winning the 133-pound title, SDSU's first Big 12 champion. David Kosher at 174 pounds took third. He earned an automatic berth into the NCAA championships. Likewise for 197-pounder Nate Rodert, who also placed third. Luke Zilverberg at 165 and 149-pounder Alex Kosher each claimed fourth place and auto bids into the NCAAs, while Martin Mueller, despite finishing third at 184, did not receive a spot in the national championships. So in St. Louis for the NCAAs, SDSU ended the event in 16th place, and two Jacks claimed All-America honors, the first since SDSU moved to Division I. Gross steamrolled his way to the finals and came up 1 point shy of a national title, claiming second place and an All-America medal. Alex Kosher won 3 matches in the NCAAs, and the senior from Wagner capped off his career with an 8th place finish and All-America accolades.
What energy, what excitement there is about Chris Bono's SDSU wrestling program. And again, congratulations to 2 All-Americans, Alex Kosher and Seth Gross. We'll recap the Jackrabbit men's basketball team's campaign and their 4th NCAA tournament in the last 6 years, right after this.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
The Jackrabbit Insider continues from the home of SDSU Wrestling, men's and women's basketball and volleyball, a quiet Frost Arena here on this late March day. Well, the SDSU men's basketball program reached its fourth NCAA tournament in the last six seasons. But I don't think there's any question this was the most improbable of all of their NCAA trips.
First-year head coach T.J. Otzelberger inherited a squad that lost four guards from an NCAA tournament team, but returned two starters and freshman All-American Mike Dom. So expectations were high, but the early season results were not. The Jacks opened with 4 of 5 on the road and lost all four away from Frost, allowing 82 points per game. Returning to Sioux Falls for the Sanford Pentagon Showcase, SDSU unveiled a 1-3-1 zone defense. But after losing the first two of that event, the Yellow and Blue won 6 of their next 7, the highlight being an 88-84 overtime defeat of Murray State that saw Dom rack up 39 points and 11 rebounds. And even after a loss at Wichita State to end the non-conference, there was a lot of optimism as the team entered the Summit League schedule. And the Jacks opened up the conference slate hosting rivals North Dakota State and South Dakota in Frost Arena. SDSU built up a 16-point second-half lead against the Bison, only to see everything go off the rails down the stretch. 3 days later, the Jacks saw an 8-point halftime lead dissipate against the Coyotes, but they rallied together, and Dom's jumper with just over a second remaining propelled SDSU to a 73-72 win. But things would get worse. Road losses at Western Illinois, IUPUI, and Oral Roberts, combined with a home defeat at the hands of Omaha, a game the Jacks trailed by 24 in the second half, had SDSU at the bottom of the Summit League standings at 1-5. The tide was somewhat stemmed on January 21st against Fort Wayne. Dom made a school record 10 three-pointers en route to 42 points. A.J. Hess hit 6 threes, and the Jacks were victorious 77-67. But less than a week later, another road loss, this time at Denver, saw Hess go down with a significant injury to his shooting elbow. SDSU was 9-14 overall, 2-6 in the league, and now missing its second leading scorer. But what happened on January 28th in Omaha, Nebraska, is something that will be remembered for years to come. Michael Loris, Chris Howell, and Lane Severin all played at least 28 minutes. Now that's a trio that combined just 7 minutes per game in the non-conference. 5 scored in double figures. Yes, Dom had 33, but Howell had a career-high 16. Reed Tellinghuesen added 13, and Severin set new career bests with 11 points and 7 boards. Howell's 2 late free throws sealed an 88-84 road win, a turning point. For the Jacks would win 6 of their last 8, buckling down defensively while attacking the glass with great vigor. A 4 seed in the Summit League tournament, the Jacks controlled virtually the entire way in an opening round 10-point win over Denver, and it really wasn't that close. then the semifinals against USD. The two regular season games were decided by a grand total of 3 points, with the home team winning each meeting. The top-seeded Coyotes exploded early, building a 16-point first-half lead, and the Jacks struggled to find an offensive rhythm aside from Orris. The graduate transfer scored 15 of the Jacks' 33 in the first half. He was 5 of 8, the rest of the team 6 of 23. An SDSU trailed by 11 at the break. Down 13 with 13 to play, Severin scored on a putback. Another offensive rebound led to a Skyler Flatten triple. And the next trip down the floor, Dom finished. A 7-0 spurt that brought the Jacks within 6. Howell skillfully found his way to the rim, and SDSU kept chipping away, but never could attain the lead. USD went to the free throw line up by a point, and 13 seconds remained.
Front end for the freshman. He missed it. Dom the rebound. 10 seconds left. Jacks down 1. Orris into the front court. 7 seconds left. 5 left. Orris left wing. 3 seconds left. 18-footer. Good! With 1.4 of a second left. And a timeout to the Coyotes. Michael Orris.
Orris was the hero, and State was the victor. 74-71. On to the championship and Hal Finning, that same Omaha team against whom SDSU had turned its season around 6 weeks prior, now stood between the Jacks and the NCAA tournament. But on this night, the Summit League Player of the Year was not to be denied. Mike Dom scored 37 points on 24 shots, making 14 of them. He hit 5 threes and corralled 12 rebounds. The Jacks were plus 19 on the glass and only missed 1 free throw. However, up 2 with seconds left, that only miss at the line would give the Mavericks a last gasp.
1-1, around and out, rebound Hollins. 6 seconds left, Omaha down 2. Hollins front court, 3 seconds left, over Howell, a long 3. Banks, no good, rebound to South Dakota State. It is a perfect finish to an imperfect season. South Dakota State has won the Summit League Tournament.
SDSU was never over 500 until the win over USD in the tournament semifinals, and yet the Jacks are going to the NCAA tournament. And as a 16 seed, they were not intimidated by the top-seeded Gonzaga Bulldogs. In fact, the Bulldogs did not lead for the first 17 minutes, as the Jacks were able to control the pace. But the Bulldogs are one of the best teams in the nation for a reason, and eventually their talent and athleticism proved to be too much for the Jacks. SDSU held Gonzaga to a season-low 66 points, but saw their season end in an opening round in Salt Lake City, Utah. Orris and Hess, the two graduate transfers, saw their careers end last week, and virtually everyone else returns. Combined with a highly rated recruiting class, Otzelberger and the Jacks have their sights set on a return to the big dance.
Can't wait to see what's in store for the Jackrabbit men's basketball program next season. We'll recap the SDSU women's basketball team's 2016-17 year after this week's Jackrabbit Legend.
Perhaps the greatest pitcher in SDSU history, Trevor Schulte is this week's Jackrabbit Legend, presented by Legend Seeds. The southpaw from Montevideo, Minnesota, won 5 games his first 2 seasons in yellow and blue. He lost each of his first 2 starts his junior year, but would not lose again for 14 months. He went 10-2 in 1993, adding a save while compiling a 2.25 earned run average. Opponents hit just 198 off Schulte, who earned All-America honors as his squad won a school record 39 games. SDSU won 39 again in 94. Schulte went 11-1 his senior year with 100 strikeouts in 85 innings. He won 21 consecutive games over that 2-year stretch, an NCAA record. That still stands. His 26 wins and .839 winning percentage for his career are program records, and he's second in SDSU annals with 226 strikeouts. Pitcher Trevor Schulte, a Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties!
And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy, answers, yield.
If you hear the students doing a chant, let's all join in. It helps create that great home court advantage we've come to know at Frost Arena. Let's go, Jacks!
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great.
Back inside Frost Arena and more of our winter sports year in review on this week's Jackrabbit Insider. And now we turn our focus to a program that has gone to a postseason for the 11th straight year in Division I, Aaron Johnston and the Jackrabbit women's basketball team.
With all five starters named preseason All-Conference and a team coming off an NCAA tournament win, Aaron Johnston's program thought everything and anything was possible, and it certainly started that way. A win over powerhouse Creighton in Frost Arena started the year right. After two dominant wins, SDSU then claimed a 66-64 road victory at Big Ten Iowa on Macy Miller's game-winning jumper. A loss at 13th-ranked Oklahoma did not deter the Jacks, who recorded impressive road wins over NCAA qualifier Northern Iowa and the Big Sky regular season champion North Dakota. At 7-1, the Jacks prepared for a showdown with another mid-major power, the Phoenix of Green Bay. A one-point lead after the first gave way to a disastrous second period. Not only did the visitors drop four threes, but Miller suffered a non-contact injury just before the half, and she would be lost for the year. Shell-shocked, the Jacks would struggle through the second half of a home loss. They overcame an 18-point first quarter deficit 2 days later, rallying together to defeat George Washington. But this was a team that needed time to heal, and a blowout loss at 8th-ranked Louisville was further proof of that. Aaron Johnston is one of the top women's basketball coaches in the nation, however, and he led his team through this difficult time, only to see another detour on the winding road that was the 2016-17 season. In a 20-point road win at Wichita State, Clarissa Ober suffered a knee injury, and the Jacks would open league play down two starters. They began the slate at North Dakota State and then South Dakota. After a split, State would win six straight. Ober returned in a 68-49 drubbing of IUPUI, and the Jacks were atop the Summit League. But life on the road is hard. Second half leads at Omaha, IUPUI, and Western Illinois were all lost, as the Jacks finished third in a conference that was as strong as maybe it's ever been. On to the league tournament in Sioux Falls. Sixth seed Oral Roberts, and they proved just how strong the league is, holding a three-point lead into the third quarter. Then the Jacks turned it on, and then some. Ellie Thompson. Ober. Madison Giebert. Kerry Young scored eight straight in the fourth. The Jacks ran away from the Golden Eagles 65-50 to earn a rubber game in the season series with IUPUI. And neither team could distance themselves through four quarters of the semifinals. Lexi Alexander's offensive rebound and score with 1 minute left was the game's eighth tie, and it sent the contest into overtime. Giebert scored eight in the extra session, but it wasn't enough. Jaguars 65, Jackrabbits 61 in overtime. A reminder of just how good SDSU was during the regular season was the NCAA Selection Committee's announcement that the Jacks were one of the last four teams left out of the big dance. Considered all the way to the end, but just barely missing the tournament. So AJ's bunch regrouped for the WNIT in an opening round shootout with the offensive-minded Huskies of Northern Illinois. Ober was sensational. 17 points, 20 rebounds, and 6 blocks. And this was the exclamation point. A block, rebound, and coast-to-coast drive and finish. Young hit 5 threes en route to a career-best 28 points. Thompson added a double-double, 14 points and 11 rebounds. SDSU 94, Huskies 84. A talented group of Pac-12 Buffaloes from Colorado entered Frost Arena for round 2 last Sunday, and the almost 3,000 fans in Frost were entertained by a back-and-forth offensive showcase. Trailing by 13 with 6 minutes to play, SDSU hit 4 from long range in the span of 126 seconds. First, it was Ober, then Giebert with the step back. And back-to-back triples from Thompson. Giebert tied the game with 36 seconds left. State actually had a chance at the end of regulation. But alas, it was not to be, and overtime would yet again occur in a postseason game. Young did everything she could to extend her career. She hit 2 threes in a 5-second span. But Colorado ended SDSU's season 81-75. So the Jacks' year came to an end at 23-9. This was their second-best RPI of the Division I era. Wins over multiple NCAA tournament teams. And this all despite missing Miller most of the year and Ober for a month. Young, Ober, and Ina Viso all graduate. Young averaged 14 points while leading the team in assists with 110. Ober, twice the Summit League's Defensive Player of the Year, racked up 47 blocks while tallying 10 points and 8 boards a game. And Viso hit 13 threes while playing 11 minutes a night. But SDSU returns Giebert, who hit 98 threes. Thompson, a 13-point and 7-rebound-a-game producer. And Alexander, who stepped in during Miller's absence and turned into a rock in the backcourt. Sidney Tracy and Sidney Palmer off the bench return, and then Miller is expected back after the injury, along with redshirts China Stevens and Tagan Larson. Oh, and did I mention the incoming class of recruits will feature the Players of the Year in both North Dakota and South Dakota? A lot of reason to be optimistic about the upcoming year for Aaron Johnston and the SDSU women's basketball team. We'll look ahead to the spring sports season in just a moment.
To me, sustainability means being able to feed the world in the future.
We need to produce more with less.
It's knowing that our soil is going to be in better shape this year than it was the year before.
We need to stop erosion at the top of the hill, not at the bottom.
We find that we can merge sustainable practices with profitability.
It's about caring for the land.
It's about passing it on to the next generation.
It's about doing the right thing. I have a responsibility.
For the people of South Dakota.
To feed the world.
The future of farming is very bright.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
Steve Halverson.
Al Muron.
This is farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
Back inside Frost Arena and more of this week's Jackrabbit Insider. This place is a little quieter than it is during the winter sports season, but a lot is happening outdoors. Let's have a look at what's to come in this year's spring schedule.
First off, a thanks to all the great fans of SDSU Athletics. With your help, the Jackrabbits Student Athlete Advisory Committee won the Summit League food fight for the fifth straight year, raising a record 43,849 pounds. The women's golf team is picking up where they left off last fall. After winning three events during the fall slate, the Jacks have won two this month, and they have one event left, the Kansas City Shootout, in a couple of weeks, before participating in the Summit League Championships that will be in Nebraska at the end of next month. Meanwhile, men's golf will partake in two more events before the Summit League Championships, which are set for Newton, Kansas, April 30th through May the 2nd. The Jackrabbit baseball team has had an impressive couple of weeks. First, SDSU went to Oklahoma State and notched a win over the top 20 ranked Cowboys. Then last weekend, they went to Omaha and swept the Mavericks to begin Summit League play 3-0. The Jacks were at Oral Roberts this week, but are scheduled to host Fort Wayne this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at Irv Heater Field in Brookings. Softball opened league play this weekend at IUPUI. Krista Woods' bunch will be in Vermilion to take on USD this Friday and Saturday. And the home opener is set for April 14th and 15th when Fort Wayne comes to Brookings. And men's and women's track and field began their outdoor schedule this weekend in Fayetteville, Arkansas. It's the typical busy spring set of events, including a handful in South Dakota. That's before the Summit League Championships in May on the North Dakota State campus in Fargo. Finally, spring football started last weekend with practices held inside the Sanford Jackrabbit Athletic Complex. The team will work out 3 days a week up until the spring game, which is set for April 22nd at 10 a.m. inside Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium.
Spring football, baseball, softball, you name it, a lot happening here on the SDSU campus in the upcoming weeks as we get to really into the thick of things for the spring sports season. Well, you hope you enjoyed this week's Insider. We'll have some special episodes coming up to take you through the months of April, May, and June. And we thank all of you for joining us throughout this winter sports season. So from the home of Jackrabbit basketball, wrestling, and volleyball, Frost Arena, I'm Tyler Merriam, and we'll see you next time on the Jackrabbit Insider.